I'm Sharon Macklis at IDG Communications, here with Do More with R, Episode 25, Customize ggplot with bbplot. One of the great things about the ggplot2 package is how powerful and flexible it is. There are so many things you can customize in a step-by-step process: colors, fonts, grid lines. But if you're not a design professional, all those choices can be a bit overwhelming. Good news is, there are skilled designers who've created ggplot themes and shared them. You can either use one of those as is, or add your own tweaks to a theme and make it your own. The BBC uses R and ggplot for some of their graphics. The BBC data team created their own ggplot theme and package, and then kindly posted the code on GitHub so all of us can use it too. They even published a cookbook online explaining how to use it. That's at bbc.github.io/rcookbook. So let's head over there. And let's look at the simple line chart code example in the cookbook. We'll be making this using Gapminder data from the Gapminder package. bbplot isn't on CRAN, so you'll need to use a package like DevTools, Remotes, or Pacman to install it. BBC uses Pacman to load packages in its cookbook, so I will too. This second line of code will install the bbplot package from the BBC's GitHub repo if it's not on your system now. If it is on your system, that code just loads the package if it's already there. The first line installs any packages that aren't on your system from CRAN and just loads them if they're already there. So let me run both of these. Now I'll create the first basic line chart in the BBC cookbook, but using ggplot defaults. So let's get the data for China from Gapminder and then run the plot code. Here are the ggplot defaults. If you're a ggplot user, you're probably already familiar with them. And there it is, a little bit larger. Next, look what happens to that graph if I add the bbc_style function from the bbplot package. I'll run the code again with the new style. Definitely a different look. We can see what's going on under the hood by running bbc_style in the console without parentheses. And you can see all the code that makes up that function. But for better code format and readability, go to the bbplot GitHub repo and find the R file. Here's the bbplot repo at github.com/bbc/bbplot. I'll go into the R folder and open the BBC style R file. I'll click the raw button so I can copy and paste this into my own file, back in RStudio. You can see the code is nicely commented, so you can tell what the code is doing in each block. I can make my own slightly modified personal function based on this with a couple of my own tweaks. So say, for an easy example, I'd like my plot title and subtitle centered. I'll turn bbc_style into my own new function. I'll call it my_tweaks_bbcstyle. And then add a little code. The code to center text in ggplot is hjust equals 0.5 in the element_text function. So I'll add that here to the plot title. And subtitle. and then source the new function by defining it and running this code. And then I'll run it on my line chart. As you can see, my headline and subtitle are now centered. There's obviously a lot more in here you can tweak. Do your tweaks and then save your function. You can save it in a file that you source whenever creating visualizations, maybe in your own GitHub repo or other public file so your code is reproducible by others. Or you can add a function like that to be part of your own personal R package. Don't know how to create your own R package? Check out episode 22 of Do More with R, Write Your Own R Package, either at infoworld.com or on YouTube's IDG Tech Talk channel. And that's it for this episode. Thanks for watching. For more R tips, head to the Do More with R page at go.infoworld.com/morewithr, all lowercase except for the R. You can also find the Do More with R playlist on the YouTube IDG Tech Talk channel. Hope to see you next episode.